Dear participants, first of all, I would like to thank the organizers of the conference who at this difficult time decided not to postpone and to hold the conference, and especially Alexander Fratkov, who became the inspirer of this session on the history of nonlinear systems and control. We dedicate our presentation to the memory of outstanding scientists with whom we have worked for a long time and from whom we have learned so much, to Professor Gennady Leonov. He obtained a number of important results in the theory of global stability and the theory of hidden oscillations, which will be discussed in this report. This report was prepared by former students of Gennady Leonov at the Department of Applied Cybernetics, St. Petersburg State University: Елена Кудряшова, Ольга Кузнецова, Михаил Лобачев, Марат Юлдашев, Ренат Юлдашев, his former student and close friend Сергей Абрамович, now working in USA, his colleague Ефим Розенвассер, and me. We would like to thank Felix Чернауська, Александр Фродков, Александр Куржанский, Владимир Разван, and Станислав Васильев for valuable comments. I ask Михаил to continue our presentation. Please, Михаил.
One of the key tasks of the control systems analysis is study of stability and limit dynamic regimes. A classical example of a mathematical approach to this problem is Vyshnegradsky's work on the analysis of Watt governor. In his work, Ivan Alexeyevich Vyshnegradsky, professor of Petersburg Institute of Technology, suggested a mathematical model of the system steam engine Watt governor, described by the third order system of ordinary differential equations with one discontinuous nonlinearity sign, which characterizes dry friction. For the linearization of this model obtained by discarding dry friction, he determined conditions which were supposed to provide local stability for the stationary regime of Watt governor. Moreover, based on engineering reasonings, he conjectured that the obtained conditions are sufficient for the absence of unwanted oscillations and for the transition to sustainable stationary regime with any initial data. Vyshnegradsky's conclusion allowed engineers to achieve stable operation of steam engines with Watt governors. Similar studies were also done by Maxwell and Stadola. Later, in 1885, a French engineer André Lyoté published a paper which showed that governors with dry friction may exhibit non-stationary sustainable regimes. Based on that, famous Russian scientist Nikolai Yegorovich Zhukovsky criticized Vyshnegradsky's approach and posed problems on rigorous non-local analysis of discontinuous systems and the proof of the Vyshnegradsky's conjecture on the stability of the Watt governor. Vyshnegradsky's work stimulated Alexander Mikhailovich Lipunov, who that time was a second-year student in St. Petersburg University, for further work on rigorous justification of the linearization procedure. Significant contribution to the study of oscillations and criteria of its absence was made by Andronov's scientific school. Alexander Alexandrovich Andronov combined Lipunov's ideas of local stability and Poincaré's limit cycles, which allowed him to construct a theory of oscillations that will explain the behavior of various engineering systems. The famous monograph Theory of Oscillations, first published in 1937, contains the analysis of stability and oscillations of various continuous and discontinuous two-dimensional dynamical models. A few years later, in 1941, similar ideas were published by famous French scientist Rocard. Developing this theory further, Andronov and Meyer studied the three-dimensional nonlinear discontinuous model from Vyshnegradsky's work and proved that his conjecture is true, that Vyshnegradsky's conditions of local stability implies absence of oscillation in the nonlinear discontinuous model and hence its global stability. Full solution of this problem was published in two numbers of journal Automatica e Telemechanica and occupied 45 pages. Nowadays, using the achievements of the theory of global stability, the Vyshnegradsky's conjecture can be proved very concisely by the consideration of the following discontinuous Lipunov function. Next, we consider the development of the global stability theory, which made this possible. As the first step in establishing the theory of global stability of control systems, we may call the work of St. Petersburg professor Anatoly Isakovich Lurie and young postdoc Vladimir Nikolaevich Postnikov. In 1944, because of the Second World War, Lurie was evacuated and worked in Sverdlovsk. nowadays Ekaterinburg, where he chaired the Department of Theoretical Mechanics at the Ural Industrial Institute. During these years, such famous scientists as Yael Gilevich Malkin, who was Postnikov's supervisor, Evgeny Alexeyevich Barbashin and Nikolai Nikolaevich Krasovsky also worked and studied in Ekaterinburg, and scientific seminars on analytical mechanics, on control theory, on stability of motion, and on nonlinear oscillations were held under the guidance of Lurie and Malkin. Lurie and Postnikov considered the following class of control systems, called now the Lurie systems, where phi is continuous scalar nonlinearity, p is matrix, q and r are vectors. They proposed to use the Lyapunov function of quadratic path plus integral of nonlinearity form for the global stability analysis. Nowadays, this class of functions became known as Lyapunov functions of the Lurie-Postnikov form. The next important step for the development of the general theory of global stability became the Eisermann's conjecture on the global stability of Lurie systems. In 1949, Mark Aronovich Eisermann, who became acquainted with the Andronov-Meyer results on the stability of the Watt governor at Andronov's seminar in Moscow, formulated his famous conjecture: is the Lurie system with one equilibrium globally stable if the nonlinearity belongs to the sector of linear stability? Later, similar conjecture was formulated by Rudolf Kalman. Working on the Eisermann's conjecture for two-dimensional system, Krasovsky obtained a sufficient condition for the global stability by Lyapunov function of the Lurie-Postnikov form, and also elaborated a counterexample to the conjecture. Thus, the Vyshnegradsky's conjecture and its proof by Andronov and Meyer, Lurie-Postnikov approach, Eisermann's conjecture and counterexample of Krasovsky led to the birth of the global stability theory. In 1952, developing his ideas, Krasovsky, together with Barbashin, published a paper with general theorem on global stability for autonomous systems of ordinary differential equations that became the foundation of the theory of global stability. In that paper, the radial unboundedness condition, which is the third condition in the theorem, was introduced. This condition allows for conclusions to be made both on local and global stability. Also, in this article, there was an example showing the radial unboundedness condition is an important one. For the proposed system with a single equilibrium, it's possible to choose positive definite Lyapunov function, which derivative is negative definite one. However, there is a domain of instability in the system. Later, various generalizations of this approach were suggested, for example, by LaSalle. One of the important classes of control systems is the Lurie systems with periodic nonlinearity, having an infinite number of equilibrium points, which makes it impossible to analyze them using the classical theorems of Barbashin-Krasovsky and LaSalle. Following the ideas of Lurie, in 1959 Russian military engineer Yuri Nikolaevich Bakayev suggested to use periodic Lyapunov functions of the Lurie-Postnikov form for the study of such systems. In the 70s, generalizing Bakayev's ideas, Gennady Alexeyevich Leonov formulated and rigorously proved an analog of Barbashin-Krasovsky theorem for the cylindrical phase space. Consider its application for the second-order phase-locked loop model. Choosing periodic Lyapunov function of Lurie-Postnikov form, which derivative is negative for any non-stationary solution, we conclude that this model is globally stable for any parameters tau 1, tau 2, kVCO and omega E3. Finally, consider a class of systems with discontinuous right-hand sides, one of which was in the beginning of this presentation. Filipov's construction of a general mathematical theory that reflects the peculiarities of the discontinuous system's behavior found in applied problems made it possible to generalize the ideas of global analysis for such systems by Lyapunov functions. The key step was the transition to differential inclusions and the consideration of the solution as absolutely continuous function. The generalization of the global stability theorems for the discontinuous systems and the differential inclusions was carried out by Arkady Chaimovich Gelik and Gennady Alexeyevich Leonov in 60s and 70s. For example, an application of proposed theorem to the two-dimensional Keldysh model of flutter suppression provides the sufficient condition of global stability, which refines the estimate of global stability obtained by Keldysh via the harmonic balance method. Note that much later, similar results were published in the article of Shevitz and Padden. However, as it was noted at the first IFAC World Congress in Moscow by Burbashin, the above methods of constructing Lyapunov functions were not sufficiently effective for their use in the investigation of a concrete system. At the time, it was known that using Lyapunov function of the Lorentz-Poisson form can lead to so-called Lorentz resolving equations, which solvability provides sufficient conditions of global stability of Lorentz systems. Anatoly Isakovich Lorentz and Efim Natanovich Rosenwasser made a presentation at the first IFAC Congress about these equations. However, determination of global stability conditions by this method is a difficult task. Another criterion presented at the first IFAC Congress was Popov criterion, which was published in 1959 in Romanian journal. Vasily Mikhail Popov, as an electrical engineer, was familiar with frequency characteristics and suggested his criterion in these terms. Also, Popov proved that the existence of a Lyapunov function of the Lorentz-Poisson form is a sufficient condition for his criterion fulfillment, and stated the converse problem. Is the Lyapunov function existence necessary for his criterion? In 1962, Vladimir Andreevich Yakubovich formulated the first version of frequency theorem on matrix inequalities, which nowadays is known as Kip lemma, and stated that the converse to Popov's statement, that is the necessity of a Lyapunov function of the Lorentz-Poisson form existing for the Popov criterion fulfillment, follows from Kip lemma with some additions. A year later, detailed explanation of required additions was published by Rosenwasser, and moreover, he showed that Popov criterion is also equivalent to solvability of Lorentz resolving equations. At the same year, similar results were published independently by Kalman. In 1962, Rosenwasser noted that the same approach with a Lyapunov function of the quadratic form allows to obtain the similar criterion for non-autonomous systems and presented this result at Yakubovich's seminar. Yakubovich generalized Rosenwasser's criterion for systems with hysteresis nonlinearities, and the both articles were published in 1963. Nowadays, this criterion is known as Sokol criterion. Remark that the described criteria and its modifications provide only sufficient conditions of global stability, and obtaining necessary and sufficient conditions is a challenging problem related to the analysis of the boundaries of the global stability in the parameters space and the birth of oscillations. Within the framework of global stability study, it's naturally to classify oscillations in control systems as self-excited or hidden. Basing of attraction of a hidden oscillation in the phase space doesn't intersect with small neighborhoods of any equilibria, whereas a self-excited oscillation is excited from an unstable equilibrium. Self-excited oscillations can be identified by the study of equilibria and computation of trajectories from their vicinities. However, the revealing of hidden oscillations and obtain initial data for their computation demands the application of special analytical numerical methods, being developed in the theory of hidden oscillations. The loss of global stability may occur by appearance of either non-trivial self-excited oscillations or a hidden one. Let us consider a two-dimensional phase-locked loop model having triangular phase detector characteristic. For fixed loop filter parameters tau1 and tau2, we analyze global stability for the remained parameters. Here the upper estimate, which is a blue curve, is determined by the loss of local stability of the stationary set, and the dashed curve is determined by the birth of semi-stable cycle, which is a hidden oscillation. The domain between blue curve and dashed curve confirms that the studying only self-exciting oscillations is not sufficient for determination of global stability boundary, and all kinds of oscillations should be analyzed for accurate global stability boundary determination. Finally, let us consider again what governor, namely its modification with Sivamoto. In this case, one more first-order equation is added that leads to four-dimensional system of discontinuous differential equations. Sufficient global stability conditions can be obtained via the considered approaches. For example, if parameter A equals to 1.4, B equals to 1, and alpha is less than 4/10, then the system is globally stable according to the proposed condition. At the same time, for a bigger value of parameter alpha, there exists an undesired oscillation, which shows the loss of global stability. In the numerical analysis of this system and smoothing of nonlinearity according to the Eisenman-Piatnitsky procedure, this oscillation will be hidden, and we will get a counterexample to the Eisenman and Kalman conjectures. The main references are presented on these two slides. Thank you for your attention.